Okay, so what we've got here is a very small DC battery charger generator. Using a 3-horsepower Lee fan motor available from Amazon for roughly $100, and an alternator with no regulator in it from Epicenter. It's a Delco-Remy. I was going to get a single wire alternator with a built-in regulator, but was told by Epicenter that this small motor probably wouldn't run it. So I took his advice and I'm controlling the alternator with an external rheostat, which changes the field and changes the output of the alternator by hand, which really works well because the motor keeps running. That way it doesn't stall out, and you can adjust how much output that the amps are, and the voltage. You can actually, you can see over here, I've got an ammeter and a voltmeter, and the you can adjust the voltage output by the RPMs of the motor, and you can adjust the amps by the rheostat. The rheostat is running through the, well, the wiring. I should probably show you the schematic. Brian at Epicenter was a lot of help. He sold me the alternator plate, which you can see on the side here, and gave me the advice on how to run this small motor. The motor, again, I paid $119 for off of Amazon, the Lee fan, and all the parts I bought from Epicenter were roughly $100. So that's about $200. So at the most, I spent $250. And I can charge up my solar system, my off-grid solar system with it. Alright, that's it. Okay, so now it's working. Alright, so now we're going to start it. And you can see for yourself how this system works with the dialing up and down the rheostat. If you remember, it has a rheostat, not a voltage regulator on it, so that white knob right here, we're going to dial this thing up and down. I won't be able to talk while this thing is running because the muffler on this small motor is not very effective. And so we're going to demonstrate how turning up the rheostat changes the amps and how turning up the engine speed changes the volts. So everything is adjustable by hand when you don't have an internal regulator, which we're about to demonstrate. Okay, here we go.
Reading 20 amps. you can go up to 30 amps if you want to. Dial it up to 30 amps. 30 amps, and you can see the motor is laboring to do 30 amps. Now the voltage is what the voltage, what the battery bank is right now. Okay.
So that's it. So you can adjust the voltage output, and you can adjust the amps using the rheostat. All right. If you have any questions, you can get a hold of epicenter.com. So here's the schematic that I used. The rheostat is shown here. And then there's also a switch that needs to be used to start up the motor without the switch being turned on. Because if you have the switch turned on or hooked up to the alternator, sometimes it may not, the motor may not want to start. The alternator would be under load. Okay, so there's that. Here's the real easy schematic for the ammeter. There's a shunt underneath it, and the ammeter I bought off of eBay, and the shunt was included. That's how the shunt works. It just the ammeter hooks to the shunt, and the shunt delivers the large output from the generator on the left to the load or your battery on the right. Because obviously you can't run all that power through the ammeter. It would, I don't know, I guess it would burn it out.